And
we're back for the knife and outdoor gear enthusiasts.
Cee and
Just Jul.
With AK Blade, your weekly knife hookup.
This time it's new knives and gear from Kansept.
Kizer.
Spyderco.
Kershaw.
And Tekto.
Let's get this blade talk started. The new Kershaw Launch 16.
Yep. So a very short cooldown period between the 15 and 16, but we're not complaining. So this auto is 8.35 inches overall with a 3.45 inch Tanto CPM M4 steel blade with partial serrations, black Cerakote finish, 0.16 inch thickness, and oversized jimping. Again, we're not complaining.
I'm not complaining. Handle is black anodized aluminum with track tech inserts and finger choil for extra security.
Yay!
Also has a reversible deep carry pocket clip and lanyard hole.
Yep. So made in the USA, as proclaimed here on their little emblem, which you can see on this guy. The blade on this one is deployed with, hold on,
bam,
a low profile push button and is disengaged with the same button. Get the new Kershaw Launch 16 for only $148.85 from
AtlanticKnife.com. Wow, you said that like it was my turn.
Okay, you first.
All right, well, I'm not complaining at all. I think it's a bargain. This thing's $200 at Kershaw's website. Mm-hmm. Everywhere you look, we got it for $148. I'd pick it up today. I like the serration part. I'm normally not a big...
Cut some rope with that.
They look very veffy, but they're not.
Whoa.
Well, look at them.
Whoa.
They're not. All right, so... I like the blade style. Actually, this is probably going to be...
Don't say it.
My favorite launch.
What? Oh my god.
Yeah, I like the little 7500 BLK. I like a couple of them. But this one, I think... I'm not a huge fan of this tire tread or whatever they called it. Track tech. I mean, it's not bad. It's nice. And I wish the button were... If you got a gigantic finger... It's kind of, or big.
Yeah, but this way it doesn't get pushed in your pocket accidentally.
Yeah, I get that part too. So, I'm in for that one.
I like it. Unlike C, it's not my favorite of the entire series. But it's definitely a contender for like 2, 3, 4 favorite spot. So this model does have a very thick blade profile. The jimping is phenomenal.
You got jimping for days.
It's nice jimping. I do think the handle could have been just a little wider for guys, because I feel like just a little bigger would have been perfect.
I think it's good.
But that's like the only thing I would change. Inserts add that roughness that you kind of need over the aluminum so it's not smooth. And the M4 steel, excellent edge retention, hardness. And the finish, of course, helps prevent against corrosion and rust.
Mm-hmm.
This here is a quality Kershaw. For a quality Kershaw price, of course.
All right. Can't beat that.
Uh-huh.
On to the latest Kansept Shard. Pull her out.
Yeah.
So, for Blade Show 2023, Kansept had a lot of their popular knives redone.
I just want to look at it.
They put them in new materials and styles, like the Corvid XL, the Model 6, the Fin Rear, and their ever-popular Shard.
Yep. So, this new Shard sports Kansept's, I'm going to say, iconic lightning design on both sides of the anodized titanium. And it covers the entire surface. It's not just an insert. It's the entire handle. Very smooth action with the knife's jimped flipper stud. Look at that. This version has a 3.48 reverse Tanto S35VN blade with satin finish and a 0.137-inch thickness flat grind and plain edge.
Wow.
I know.
Designed by Kim Ning. This frame lock also features a tip-up titanium lightning pocket clip. Comes with a pouch.
Oh.
Cleaning cloth. I ain't gonna throw them. And stickers. Get to striking that pose with the Kansept Shard in lightning.
Yeah, I'm gonna stab you while doing it.
Just $193.20 from AtlanticKnife.com.
How'd you go? I voked him in the face.
Yeah.
I like the Shard. It's one of their most popular knives for a reason. This one opens smoothly, cuts smoothly, closes smoothly, looks awesome. It's a smooth operator, this Shard. This is nice. Quality all around. I think Kansept could be wee if they did these in limited editions, like numbered them and said they only did 200 or 150. And if they promoted it a little, I feel like they could be wee with these. Actually, they could. I personally think they could be better than wee because this is, wow. And the Damascus one we did last week, wow. This is just nice. Go ahead.
I would agree. Maybe not the wee part because they lack the organization, but
ouch.
That's not a bad thing. Wee is just super organized. They got their, well, we would say, as my dad would say, got their stuff in one sock.
Got all your bag.
Yeah.
Just put it all in it.
It's one sock. They know what they're doing. They got everything planned out. Runs smoothly. Well-oiled machine. I like this knife a lot, too. I mean, they did everything. The pocket clip. I mean, they didn't anodize the screws. But I mean...
Wow.
I mean, what else? I know.
Wow.
And did you say 193? You didn't say 393?
193.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's a definite...
Get.
Can we do a thumbs up? I don't know. It's
thumbs,
even allowed.
Thumbs way up.
Wacky wacky.
Yeah.
All right.
All right, we're hitting the latest Spyderco Ambitious next. So this newest model, Ambitious Spyderco, has been released. I was actually excited about this one.
I am too.
Yeah, so I really like this knife. And now here it is in blue FRN lightweight with CPM, a 35 band steel. See? Go ahead, do the specs.
All right, this carries 5.87 inch overall when fully deployed and has a 2.31 inch CPM S35VN. Satin finish blade.
Yes.
It's about 0.118 thick.
Mm-hmm.
Jimping, flat grind, and offered a plain edge as well as fully serrated spider edge blade.
Which is the one we get.
The spider edge blade is opened with a thumb hole. We know which one.
Mm-hmm.
And is disengaged with the liner lock.
Mm-hmm. Finally, the handle is blue FRN.
Fiberglass reinforced nylon.
With the, of course, the non-slip bidirectional texturing. I know. As well as the four-position pocket clip for left, right side, tip up, or tip down carry. Finally, it's got 2.8 ounces on the scale there, and is available for only $95.20 from AtlanticKnife.com. I know. Okay. Go ahead.
Well, here is my problem. Are you ready?
No. Don't say
I really like the look of the Spidey Edge blade.
Mm-hmm.
But I like using the plain edge ones better.
Okay, I'll allow it.
That's the only problem. I mean,
I like
and there's
the look
no,
of it too.
There's no way around it.
I know.
This looks better.
It does.
The other one works better.
It does.
So, I guess I'd have to just buy both. I don't know. I think I am going to get one of these.
They're so cute.
I'm trying to get all the Spy 27 stuff still, so.
Uh-huh.
You know. Very nice. Of course, it's an ambitious, high-end.
Lightweight.
Yeah. Yeah. Fancy plastic.
Like I said, I was... Don't you?
FRN. Oof. Fancy plastic.
I was really excited about that one simply because of the steel and the color because they only had like black ones. And I think this is an excellent size for a real on-the-go. Throw in your pocket. Just go carry. That's what I feel like. I feel like most people will use this size. Lockup is always good from Spyderco and the AmbiPod clip is like the sugar on top, you know, because left-handed doing it. It is a remake of an older model.
Mm-hmm.
Which I usually don't like, but it seems to be the thing right now.
Well, you know it's coming next, K390, your teal.
But it won't change even if I say, make something completely new, Spyderco. Love to see something completely new. I'm happy with this, and it's now on my wish list.
Is it? All right.
Because I like it.
Well, we do have wish lists on our website.
Yeah, landknife.com.
It's time for our next knife, the Kizer Coniferous V.
Yep.
V is for coniferous.
Is it?
So this new Kizer comes in only one option right now, but I'm sure that will change.
Sure.
7.72 inch overall, 3.35 inch, 154 cm drop point blade, plain edge, stone wash finish, 0.12 of thickness and jimping. Blade is open with flipper tab or dual-sided thumb stud.
Working on it.
Gotcha.
There you go.
Designed by Justin Gingrich. This liner lock is an expert blend of practicality and one-of-a-kind style, as it features a unique 60-degree V-shaped angle. That's interesting.
Yeah.
So it's built for balance and strength and stability, especially during use, because you wouldn't want to be balanced and strength and stable when it's in your pocket.
Not in use, yeah. Handle is black micarta with the gray titanium back. Stainless steel liners inset inside. There's also a... I had to flip it again because I like the sound.
Mm-hmm.
Reversible tip-up deep carry pocket clip.
Everybody's catching on with that, aren't they?
Yes, and a lanyard hole.
Get you one for only $95 from AtlanticKnife.com.
All right, so really interesting design. It has everything I look for in a new knife. Flipper tab. Reversible pocket clip, lanyard hole, sharp blade, jimping. Everything you need from a knife for a knife is here. Then you add the micarta and the titanium handle into the mix, along with unique design, and it like ups it up. I have to say A for Kizer. Nice work, Justin. This is really nice.
A for Kizer.
Yes, this is nice. And the ting is...
It does. Some knives just have a sound.
They do.
Let me ask you a question.
I love the sound.
Since it's $95, would you buy that knife?
Mm-hmm.
Or the Ambitious?
No, why would you say that?
Yeah, Spyderco has a way of making a small knife seem bigger. See, I'm a big knife person, too.
Don't ask me.
I'm like, well,
it's got titanium, though. I'm
all right, so we'll let you marinate on that, and we'll talk a little bit about the Kizer there.
Here, you want to look at it.
Well, I'm like with you, the micarta, this is my type of micarta, and this is my style of blade. It is nice design. I have to give it that. $95, 154 cm. I mean, you know what? That's nice. I'd have one, too. I'd say I'd like that one also.
How about... I get one as a gift.
And put the oven on layaway.
Yeah.
Which we do not have.
That's what I do, but one day maybe. So make sure to stick around, guys, because we'll be reviewing the new Kershaw Hatch along with knives from Tekto.
Oh, right.
But first, make sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe, as well as jingle the bell. We really need you guys to spread the word. No viewers, no videos.
Yep, no ticky, no laundry.
Exactly. So go get the word out. Not only will you be helping us, but you'll also get automatically entered into giveaways. One more week for the Wii Knife Up giveaway.
That's a Min-X.
One more week, yes. It's got the Min-X and all that Wii stuff.
Awesome.
The cards and the
patches. I can't wait to win that.
And the sticker. Okay. He's not included.
We're not allowed
to. So make sure you get yourself entered before it's too late. You'll forget if you wait till the end of the video. So just like, share, comment, subscribe right now. And become an AK member to double your chances if you're not one already. Link is in the description below.
You get access to the newest knives first, as well as deals and special promos. We host, so don't wait.
You have nothing to lose and everything to gain.
Ooh.
It's a real cliche week this week.
Not shark week, cliche week.
Cliche week.
All right, with that, it's back to the table. We have the Kershaw Hatch.
Yep.
So this folder from Kershaw is only available in one option right now. I'm sure that will change.
I'm sure it will.
But don't worry, it will change. Take it away.
So it's 7.35 inches overall with a 3.15 inch D2 cleaver blade with plain edge, jimping. It's got a satin finish with stone wash grinds. No, I'm
missing it. Stone wash finish, doesn't it?
Stone wash finish, satin grind, sorry. And 0.097 inch thickness. Handle is black GFN
glass-filled nylon.
With tip-up, deep carry, reversible pocket clip. Blade is opened with the... Hold on. I just want to show you the disengage there. The dual-sided thumb studs disengaged with Kershaw's mid-lock. Mm. There it is. Yep, I know. Weighing just over 2.5 ounces. I know, it's super heavy. This carry is built to go with you wherever life takes you. Get it for just $44.85 from AtlanticKnife.com.
All right, so now you finish your spiel. Is it stonewashed?
It looks like it is, but I think I would reverse those. It looks like the blade's satin and the grinds are stonewashed. I don't know.
So this part here you think is stonewashed? And
yeah,
this part is
I think
satin.
Kershaw.
I got you. Okay, so it's close to stonewashed.
I've angered the camera girl.
Angered the gods.
Yeah.
All right, so I like the knife. I think it's a nice knife. I'm glad it's D2. It's a lockback, which is, no harm, no foul.
A little different from them, too.
Yeah, exactly. It's a good size. You can't flip it, which, you know, that's okay. We don't have to be like that on every single knife. Has good jimping and dual-sided thumb studs, dual grease traps. So I like it. Is it a little pricey? Everything's a little pricey. $44, pick one up.
Okay, so that was the positive side. It's a decent knife from Kershaw. I do like they upgraded from the typical budget-friendly steel, like 8CR and whatever.
So you promised if they did better steel.
D2.
Look how rounded this is on top.
It's really nice D2. I just think that change was.
You promised long. If they did better steel, you'd give them. You'd say nice things about.
Okay,
them.
But they're long overdue. You no, can't, is I it can't better tell steel? You to, I can't tell you hey, to listen. Change.
Let me say a word.
And then everyone else is already passed.
Let me say
it.
A word. Hold on. Kershaw, did 8CR13 come to your mind?
Yes.
Okay. See, you gotta say something nice.
But they're behind now. Everything's getting to be 154cm or better.
They are. They make a lot of knives. There are probably 100,000 of those going out this year. There's no way that they could stay ahead.
But look, we've seen this cleaver thing like 100 times over. Kershaw has even done the cleaver thing before.
Okay, we're moving on. Jill's not being nice to Kershaw. She promised she would.
Let me name them. Static, the Launch 14, the Bracket, the Strata, the other Static, the other Static.
That's not funny. There's like, clam pack Static.
No, they're different Statics. There's you. Other ones. There's a one with a P. I can't remember what it is, but that one has a cleaver bait. Look, to be honest, I'm going to be very honest with you. There are better folding cleavers at better prices. I know, like the Buck Highline.
Oh, I know what this
is
about.
The Savini Bull Mastiff.
Joel got a Corvette XL.
I like that.
I see what it is
now. The Kansept Corvette. Look.
She got one at Blade Show.
Look.
It's got an American flag on it.
Look. This for 44 or a giant Corvette with a pouch, cleaning cloth, and all the extras for an extra like $20.
You will not find that Corvette in every Lowe's in this country, and you'll find that in every Lowe's in this country.
Well, I think the extra large Corvette should be found in every Lowe's in the country.
If it was, it would not be $86. It would be $149.
What are you doing to me?
All right, moving on.
Yeah,
we're going to our friends.
Thank you. I did ramble a little bit. We're back on the road, Jack. Jeez. Next are the Tekto Alpha and Bravo. Hopefully, they do better than the last Alpha and Bravo we featured.
Alpha and Bravo we featured.
Yeah, it's okay. You don't need to bring it back up. It's
all right.
Memories.
Just so the F1 Alpha from Tekto comes in 5 options. We have the black bronze one. Anyways, this folder is 7.63-inch overall. It has a 3.13-inch D2 tool steel blade. Black titanium coating, jimping plain edge, and flat grind. Handle in this model is black G10 with bronze accents. Nice. Lanolock also has a lanyard hole, glass breaker, tip-up, reversible pocket clip.
Yay! Blade is flipped with gem flipper stud. And the whole outfit comes with a black nylon belt pouch. Look at that. See? Look at that.
That is nice. I'm going to give you that.
You can also choose from a variety of like carbon fiber handle versions or an OD green G10 one. There's also a blackout option. Some even have blue accents, so it's a nice glass breaker. Go ahead.
All right. You want me to go next?
Yeah, we're going to do the next one.
All right. So the F2 Bravo is also 7.63-inch overall.
Mm-hmm. Five options.
Is it really?
Yeah, just like the other one.
3.25-inch D2 tool steel blade. Bead blasted style finish. You finish it up. Go ahead.
Plain edge and 0.07-inch thickness. The handle on this one is the black forged carbon fiber with the silver-colored titanium accents, like the tip-up pocket clip, backspacer, pivot cap cover. There's also, all done, a lanyard hole. Go ahead.
All right. So the blade is deployed with the gent flipper. Does it have a stud?
Gent flipper stud.
Tad, right?
You call them tabs. I call them studs.
That's
whatever.
Fine. I just wanted to make sure before I went on. And disengage with liner lock. Comes with a black nylon. Is it this one?
Yes, pouch. It's a little smaller. See, look at that.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Give them the good news.
Either model starts at $140 at atlantknife.com. Go ahead.
All right.
What do you think?
Well, look.
I'm not going to say that. Okay.
These are nice knives.
I'm not going
D2
say that.
Steel, high quality. Very nicely made. I don't get the whole assembled completely almost thing or sourced by. I don't know what that means. So
you can't say
they're assembled in the United States.
They make a lot of automatic knives too.
Yeah, those should be.
Those are made.
Should be.
Say so.
But you know.
I don't know. I like the design for both of them. I just think they're a little high for D2. I mean, not Kershaw's too high. I think Tekto is a little too high.
It's a good design.
Yeah, I think they just need to upgrade their steel.
That CEO there is really nice.
It's a little thicker than a CEO, but that's what I thought when I flipped it open was a CEO, yeah. Mm-hmm. But there's a reason why people copy great things, because they're great things.
Wait, you're CRKT did a great thing?
Yes, the CEO, CRKT did a great thing there.
It's a little
good
high,
job.
Too. All right, so with that, oh my goodness.
Yep.
It's time for the final knife.
Yes.
Wow.
And and boo at the same time.
Here we go, Kansept.
Turaco.
Turaco! Yeah. Or Turaco. Three options available. Oh, well, if it was C, you are, it'd be Curacao.
Uh-huh.
Blackout. Like, bead, blasted, and bronze. Mm-hmm. We have the bronze option. So this folder is 6.72 inch with a 2.82 inch S35VN drop point blade, satin finish, flat grind, plain edge, distinct swedge. Mm-hmm. And 0.118 inch in thickness. Handle a solid bronze, anodized titanium. So that is a solid
bronze colored
anodized titanium with blue accents and tip up 3D milled integral titanium pocket clip. Show me the integral titanium pocket clip.
Right there.
Very nice.
Yeah, I know. Blade is opened with the gemmed front flipper.
Almost had a perfect week.
I know. And disengaged with frame lock. It's also got the recessed or hidden lanyard hole there. So, mm-hmm. Designed by Jared Price, a knife maker from Springfield, Missouri. Suck it, see, I said it right.
Mm-hmm.
This folder weighs just 3.8 ounces and comes with a pouch, cleaning cloth, and stickers. So you can get a new Kansept Turaco starting at only $159.89 from
LAKnife.com.
Okay,
all right. First. So this would have been my top knife of the week,
if not for
the front flipper.
Yeah. Yes, for anyone who wanted to know. Yes, our knives.
I think all
flippers.
These people have washed before.
Exactly. Well, come on.
You know, I like the hint of bronze that this thing has, and mm-hmm. they actually did anodize their screws on this one. I like that also. I like this
and
blade
the,
shape.
There's a lanyard piece in there. It's also anodized. And most people would notice.
I mean,
just put
it
the
is
in there,
all but. Around well done. I mean, everything about it. I like it a lot. Fits my hand. Could have been just a little bit longer, but you can see on a 6.62, you can still get it in there, and it doesn't really take away. It's the only detractor is the front flipper, what do you call it, fad, which is basically faded.
It should fade away.
Mm-hmm.
I think Kansept has quality
I'm gonna talk
down
it to Oblivion.
Pat, that's great. Especially when it comes to titanium and S35VN. I've never had an issue with Kansept. I never heard of anyone having an issue with a high-end Kansept.
Nope.
Never. So, I am going to sound like a broken record, but...
Bam.
No back flipper tab, no smile here. It's a little small, too, I think.
All right.
But I think it's designed for others, like the European market.
I don't know.
I feel like that's what they're at with that one.
Maybe.
I'm
going to
pretend
nice,
that's what it
it's
is.
A nice knife. That was our last knife for the week. Make sure to like, share, comment, and subscribe, as well as ring that bell. We'll be dropping 5-minute reviews and more 1-minute previews very, very soon.
Let's try to get at you.
So make sure to stay linked to AK.
And don't forget to share and comment. That way you're automatically entered to win the Wii Knife Up giveaway.
That's a Min-X. Yeah. You can double your chances by becoming an AK member. Link is in the description below. Don't forget to look us up on Facebook, Pinterest, Reddit, YouTube, Instagram, Rumble, and... Holy
smokes.
AK's blog.
We post reels, photos, and more. That was a reel. Should have pushed him over. Make sure to
I think
follow
a mountain
us.
Mountain was just created.
So never miss out on any knife and gear content. All right. With that, what was your favorite knife this week?
Oh, favorite knife this week was.
Please. We all know that's not it.
It is the Launch 16. Yes. I am a Launch guy.
That's great. We should make a shirt.
I have one of these for lunch.
I'm a Launch guy.
A Launch for lunch.
That's great. Well, I am... Oof, this is a tough call. I really like the Kansept.
Do you?
I think I'm biased, though.
I think you are also. You're starting to like Kansept a little too much.
I like Kansept. I like Bestek, too, but their new stuff hasn't come yet, so I can't fawn over it yet.
It's all right.
I like the... I'm going with the Kansept.
No harm, no foul. You could have been worse.
And Lightning.
That was a good pick.
Thank you.
All right, with that, I'm seeing this is...
Jul.
Just Jul. And we are signing off. She's just using the wrong hand.
Fine. See you then, Benny.
Combed my hair, washed and brushed my teeth. Got to bed. He said, hey, it's ready to jet. Betty's mom said,
Betty's not ready yet.
All right, let's get going. most expensive businesses. Two chains. Alright, here we go. Into you. Why are you bumping into me?
Because you're kind of close.
And one.